Any moment now, an FDA panel is expected to recommend the first COVID-19 vaccine for emergency use. Here to talk about that and so much more is Dr. Todd Allerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Hospital. Thank you so much for joining us, Doctor.
So, Doctor, let's start right there. We are still waiting for that decision. The decision from the advisory committee could happen within an hour or two, and then it goes on. If the panel recommends the Pfizer vaccine tonight and the FDA approves it, walk us through what happens next. How soon could those doses actually be shipped? Walk us through, please.
What a day, Ed, and I do think the panel and the FDA will give the green light for this EUA. And then the next steps are that the company actually ships the vaccine all across the country into Massachusetts. The first shipment we're supposed to receive is 60,000 doses. Just to give you a sense, our facility at South Shore is supposed to get just under 2,000 doses. And then we begin to roll out vaccination among the frontline providers first. That's going to be in the first phase, and then also to chronic care facilities, both the staff and the residents, and then other first responders as well, police, fire, emergency medicine, public health workers, and so on. That's the first phase. That's going to last a few months, and then it will go to phase two, which are going to be patients with chronic conditions, more than one to start with, at least two chronic conditions, and then other essential workers as well, like teachers, people who work in grocery stores, transit, etc. And then after that will last a few months, and then after that, more of the general population within Massachusetts, which will be the majority.
Just as a focus, if it is approved tonight, can shots go into arms tomorrow or tonight?
Well, the answer is it can, but remember, we have to get the formal FDA approval, and then it has to get shipped. So, for instance, we're not supposed to receive our shipment before December 15th. So it's still going to take, you know, a few more days.
All right. And we know that we have AstraZeneca, and we have these vaccine candidates, Moderna. So what's the situation with them? How soon could they're in the final stages right now. How soon could those become available?
Well, it's really amazing. You know, Moderna is just basically a week behind.
Right.
Next week, the same time, the FDA advisory committee is going to go through the same process. And the Moderna efficacy and safety likely will look the same as Pfizer. Both of these, to me, look like they're home runs from an effectiveness and safety perspective. There are still groups we want to study, but in people 16 and over, this looks like high effectiveness, 95%. It looks very safe, even though there are side effects. The side effects are more than the flu shot. It's more reactive, but most of these are short-term and go away within 24 hours, whether it's fevers, aches, injection site reactions. Listen, we need to roll up our sleeves now and take these shots.
Is there any risk of getting COVID-19 from the vaccines?
Yeah, I've been asked that a few times, Ed. The answer is absolutely not. This is not a live virus. This isn't a weakened virus. This is just basically the ingredients, the genetic sequence to make a protein. And we're very used to having protein vaccines. This is just one step before it so we can scale it up. Mm-hmm. So absolutely not. You cannot get COVID-19 from the shot.
Doctor, there's a claim that's out there right now. It's spreading all over social media. And it's suggesting, and it's just a claim, and it's on social media, that there's a protein in the Pfizer vaccine that causes infertility in women. True or false?
Absolutely false. 2021 is going to be punctuated by many Americans trying to figure out when are they going to get the vaccine. But also there's going to be a group of people that are saying, there's no way I'll get the vaccine,
right,
or the vaccine causes this and that. The bottom line is, so far there have been zero safety issues from the Pfizer vaccine. We haven't heard any with the Moderna vaccine. And what they're saying is there's the spike protein. There's a very tiny sequence within that mirrors a protein on the placenta. It is so small. These proteins really don't look alike. And by the way, remember, when you get COVID-19, we haven't seen an excess number of miscarriages in women who are pregnant. If that were the case, we would expect to see it after natural infection. That is a false rumor.
Dr. Allerin, it's so great to talk with you. It's a good optimistic feel tonight after talking
Today's
with you.
Today's a great day.
Yeah.
Today's a great day. Great to see you, Doc. Be well.
Be well, Doctor.